If you type AC4Os or Intro4Os into your Google search bar, you'll find a music video written and performed by Orlando AC4Os Henderson. The song kicks off Henderson's album called Straight Out of the Cleaners, and the album's cover features AC standing in a laundromat, flicking a $100 bill at the camera as he blows a puff of smoke. However, the album cover isn't nearly as interesting as the music video, which begins with Henderson rapping as the video cross-cuts between two locations. In one spot, Henderson is sitting shirtless on a blue couch, waving around a gun. The other scene shows Henderson dancing in a gas station while holding a wad of cash. Waving dollar bills around or making it rain in music videos is quite common, a cliche by modern standards. But cash truly is everything to Henderson. His life motto is, "Ain't wit being broke," a simple phrase he uses in every facet of his life and business. But while it's easy to print the saying on t-shirts and sing it in rap songs, avoiding financial hardship can be difficult, especially if you're like Henderson, who in 2013 dropped far below broke. In 2013, Henderson filed for Chapter 13 bankruptcy, owing over $26,000 to various creditors. In July, Henderson agreed to pay them $447 per month for 60 months. However, in August, the administrators filed a motion in court to dismiss Henderson's case. Their reason? AC4Os neglected to attend a 341 meeting between him and his creditors. A 341 meeting is like an interrogation of the person in debt. It's a chance for the creditors to question them under oath about their assets and liabilities. He also failed to show up for his debtor education class, a program that helps people with poor money management skills learn how to avoid debt, which was a part of the terms he supposedly agreed to in court. Henderson was horrible with money and clearly could not be trusted. It only seems fitting that he'd eventually get a job at the bank. As you can probably guess, that bank was Wells Fargo. Henderson began working at their Charlotte location as a vault runner. To put it bluntly, the man who went bankrupt 6 years ago received the literal key to a vault filled with millions of dollars. Henderson started his new job in April of 2019. In their indictment, investigators believe Henderson wasted no time in stealing money. After working at the bank for 2 months, Henderson hatched a brilliant idea. He could steal money from the vault whenever a customer made a deposit. However, he knew he'd have to start small, so Henderson's first score was only $446. Coincidentally, a dollar less than what he'd agreed to pay his creditors back in 2013. Nobody seemed to be missing the money. To Henderson, the scheme was a success. Henderson decided to steal a little bit less the next time. Perhaps he wasn't ready to press his luck. Not just yet. His second swipe amounted to $200. A few days later, Henderson strolled back into the vault and stole another $411. You would think that someone would notice if $1,000 went missing. Apparently, nobody did. Henderson knew the bank would eventually catch on. He was smart enough to come up with ways to cover his tracks, but dumb enough to think they'd work. He created false deposit documents and even went as far as to destroy real documents filled out by customers. If there was no paper trail of the deposit, how could anyone prove the money was there to begin with? Henderson's clever cover-ups worked at first, as no one seemed to notice. To launder the stolen cash, Henderson deposited the money in a nearby ATM. Seeing the money falling into his bank account must have looked good, because the next day, on June 21st, Henderson came into work and scraped another $850 from a customer's account. From the 21st onward, a massive shift occurred in Henderson's thinking. After that $850 was deposited, the Carolina rapper started taking his embezzlement scheme to new and dangerous heights. According to investigative records, on June 24th, Henderson stole $5,400. The very next day, he stole another $5,000. The day after that, he downsized to $1,300. After the 26th, Henderson took a 5-day hiatus from ripping off Wells Fargo customers. He probably felt like he deserved a vacation. However, the hiatus only served as a consolidation period. Henderson was already riding down a slippery slope, which felt more like a high, if anything. He continued to steal cash from the vaults, this time in far larger amounts. Henderson's increasing payload played out like a 3-act play. He began slowly with the first $400, taking baby steps until he was stealing a few thousand here and there. By the show's climax, Henderson had stolen over $13,000 in 1 day before ending on one last $3,000 score. His final farewell. The grand total added up to $88,000. So, what did Henderson do with the money he stole? As mentioned before, he put some in his bank account. The deposited money, specifically $20,000, was used to put a down payment on a brand new shiny white Mercedes-Benz. Besides the car, Henderson kept most of the cash in his home, prompting one of his friends to comment on how strange it was that he kept it lying around. He wondered if Henderson had ever heard of a bank. Of course, Henderson knew more than most about banks. He knew enough about banks to forge statements, which Henderson used to finance his 2019 Mercedes, which he spent more time taking pictures of than actually driving. Henderson made sure his social media followers knew how good 2019 had been to him. One post from July 6th shows four photos of Henderson with three stacks that probably add up to $30,000. The first photo depicts Henderson hiding his face behind a fan of cash as if he's playing cards. The second was a candid shot of Henderson making it rain, and the third shows him, after apparently picking the money up, holding the greenbacks in three stacks thicker than a Harry Potter book. Then, on September 9th, Henderson posted a selfie with his white Benz. He stood in the foreground, holding a blue designer bag in his right hand, while the left gestured to the camera. And if you look close enough, you could see a shiny Gucci belt wrapped around his waist. Though there's no flaunted cash in this post, you get the message. Henderson ain't with being broke, but not so good at writing captions. Under the Benz selfie, Henderson wrote, "Brand new deposit," followed by a box emoji, an airplane, a big van, and a handicap sign. In the first post, Henderson claims he got the money out the mud after he made it out the trenches, followed by a broken down home emoji and a camera to signify where he supposedly came from and where he is now. In other words, if you were an ignorant social media scroller and happened upon Henderson's posts in 2019, you'd think he was a remarkable rags-to-riches story, not a lower middle-class man in his late 20s who stole from the bank vaults at Wells Fargo. Eventually, reality would creep up on Henderson. Eventually, bank officials became suspicious and called in investigators to determine why and how $88,000 was missing from their vault. After examining each employee, one stood above the rest, the only employee posting pictures with large amounts of cash, expensive clothes, designer accessories, and a luxury car that far surpassed his pay grade. On December 4th, 5 months after his first theft, the FBI arrested Henderson in San Diego. He was brought to a federal detention center, informed of his 19 charges, including theft, embezzlement, 12 counts of fabricating false entries, and money laundering. The feds then provided Henderson with a public defender named Benjamin Davis, who did not bother to defend his client when reporters called for interviews. Eventually, federal officials moved Henderson to the crime scene, North Carolina. Not long after his cross-state move, Henderson pleaded guilty to all charges in a federal court in Charlotte. The date was March 20th, meaning Henderson was moved around by feds like a wayward Amazon package between December and March. Nevertheless, Henderson still managed to release a new rap single. The single was called, and we're not making this up, First Day Out. On January 11th, only a few weeks after being detained by the FBI, Henderson officially released the song on YouTube. Say what you will about Orlando Henderson, but even his harshest critics have to admit he has impeccable timing. Henderson was formally charged for his crimes and is staring down the barrel of a hefty prison sentence and multi-million dollar fine. However, Henderson is currently a free man, as he's innocent until proven guilty in court. While his case moves through the process, Henderson seems to think everything's fine. Scrolling through his social media pages, you'd never think anything bad happened. The free man posted his homecoming on Facebook, saying he was ready to conquer the summer, and conquer he did. Throughout the summer of 2021 and the subsequent fall months, Henderson wanted his followers to know he was still, quote, ain't wit being broke. 2 days after announcing his return home, Henderson posted a picture of himself on Facebook wearing a hoodie with the caption, "He put up for a min." Then, on August 28th, he posted a picture of himself standing in front of his white Mercedes, captioned, "Somewhere in the trenches in that same Benz," implying he still owns the Mercedes he bought back in 2019. It seems very odd that Henderson was able to keep the Mercedes after financing the vehicle with a falsified loan application. There is a possibility the photo Henderson posted was taken in 2019, and he added the caption to mislead people into thinking he kept the car, leaving his actual living circumstances in a shroud of fake hustle game mystery. We may never know what Henderson is really up to, but perhaps we can try to understand why. Ain't wit being broke is much more than a phrase to Henderson. It's a mindset. He lives and dies by the mantra, ain't wit being broke. He named his own record label after the motto and printed the logo on his t-shirts. However, ain't wit being broke doesn't mean Henderson avoids being broke. No, it means he avoids looking broke, as evidenced by Henderson's social media posts and the brutal reality printed on court and state documents. Ain't wit being broke is more like an exposed nerve or a real-life Achilles heel. When struck, it reveals its owner's most profound insecurities. Henderson will eventually face the music once the state is satisfied with the case against him. Until then, he remains innocent until proven guilty. Click here to watch one of these next videos. And let us know in the comments section what you'd rather do with $10,000 right now. Spend it or save it?